हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल ऑल अबाउट ब्रेकिंग एंड मेकिंग। टुडे आवर डिस्कशन विल बी ऑन हाइपर कॉन्जुगेशन व्हिच इज आल्सो कॉल्ड नो बॉन्ड रेजोनेंस। सो एट फर्स्ट वी विल नो द डेफिनेशन ऑफ हाइपर कॉन्जुगेशन। So what is the definition? When an alkyl group is attached with an unsaturated system, which can be an alkene, an alkyne, a carbocation, a phenyl ring, etc., then the alkyl group is capable of giving rise to electron release by a mechanism which is called hyperconjugation. So this is the definition of hyperconjugation. Now let us consider an example. So this part is an unsaturated system. It contains a double bond. Now here we have a CH3 group. So the orientation of these CH3s will be like this. So this CH3 group is capable of giving rise to electron release to this system, like this. Here this sigma bond is involved in overlapping. Now how it is possible? In resonance we have discussed that if there will be conjugation or there will be overlapping, then the orbitals must have to be parallel with respect to each other. But here what is the orbital picture? Let's see. This carbon center, this is sp3 orbital. Who have seen my video regarding the hybridization, they will very easily understand that this orbital is sp3 orbital, which is overlap with the 1s of hydrogen, so that this sigma bond formation is possible. Now here in case of this carbon center, this is sp2, there is an unhybridized p orbital left. Here it is hydrogen and here we have another carbon atom which is also sp2 hybridized. Now already overlapping has taken place between them. They are perfectly parallel with respect to each other, so there is no problem in overlapping. But here if this sigma electron pair have to take part with this conjugation, then this type of overlapping have to take place, which happens in reality. But the question is this overlapping is as effective as this overlapping? The answer is no, because here the overlapping takes place between two perfectly parallel p orbitals, but here this overlapping is taking place between a perfect p orbital and a sp3 hybridized orbital, which are not exactly parallel with respect to each other. They can be treated as almost parallel, but they are not exactly parallel with respect to each other. So here the overlapping is not so effective like the case of this. Okay, so this is the orbital picture. Now here comes the point that what are the differences between resonance and hyperconjugation. So resonance versus hyperconjugation. In resonance, overlapping is between p pi or p pi or d pi, etc. They are basically perfectly parallel with respect to each other. So the overlapping is very effective. Here, the overlapping is effective. In case of resonance. But in case of hyperconjugation, the overlapping is between p pi and sp3. So here it is very normal that they are not perfectly parallel. They can be treated as almost parallel, but they are not perfectly parallel with respect to each other. So here the overlapping is less effective. Okay, so this is the point number one. Now point number two, in resonance we know that the involvement of pi electron is considered, but here the involvement of sigma electron is considered. Now we know that the pi bonds are basically labile than that of sigma bond. So it is very easy to break a pi bond instead of a sigma bond. So the involvement of pi electrons will be very easy than the involvement of sigma electron. That's why the overlapping or conjugation in case of resonance is very very strong than the overlapping in hyperconjugation, which makes resonance a more powerful effect over hyperconjugation. Okay, now we will discuss the classification of hyperconjugation. Hyperconjugation is of two types. One is isovalent and the other is sacrificial. In case of isovalent hyperconjugation, the unsaturated system is a carbocation. But in case of sacrificial hyperconjugation, the unsaturated system may be a double bond or a triple bond. Now the example of sacrificial hyperconjugation we have discussed here before. This type of hyperconjugation is an example of sacrificial hyperconjugation, where the unsaturated system is a double bond. It can be a triple bond also. But now we will discuss about isovalent hyperconjugation. Okay, so one is isovalent and another is sacrificial. Now let us consider the tertiary butyl carbocation. So this is the tertiary butyl carbocation. It's a 3 degree carbocation because to the cationic carbon center there are 3 carbon atoms are attached. That's why it is 3 degree. Now the involvement of sigma electron will be like this. Any one of these CH bonds can take part. What does it result? Like this. Okay. Now a question may arise. this H plus ion. Why this H plus ion is mentioned here? After the involvement of this bond, this H plus ion should be free, as we have seen in the case of acidity. But here, the case is not like the case of acidity. Here, basically, this H plus ion is associated with this pi electron cloud with the help of Coulombic force of attraction. Okay, so there is Coulombic force of attraction. That's why this H plus ion is not free to move. But there is no real bond between this hydrogen and the electron density cloud or the carbon. That's why it is called no bond resonance. Who have seen my video regarding resonance will definitely understand the case is very similar like the case of resonance. Only the difference is the involvement of the sigma electron in place of pi electron. In resonance, this type of H plus release does not take place. But here, this H plus release is taking place. But this H plus is not actually free to move. It is attached to the electron density cloud of the system with the help of Coulombic force of attraction. As there is no bond between the H plus and the electron cloud, that's why it is called no bond resonance. Because it is almost equivalent to resonance. Now we will know how to calculate the number of hyperconjugative structure, HPC structure. The hyperconjugation is abbreviated as HPC and the structure is STR. Okay. So how to calculate the number of hyperconjugative structure? It is only one rule. As the number of alpha hydrogen atom present in the system, that will be the number of hyperconjugative structure in the system. So this is the one and only rule to determine the number of hyperconjugative structure. Now what is alpha hydrogen atom? Here, this carbocationic center is attached to three alkyl groups. Now, the carbon atoms directly attached to the cationic carbon center are called alpha carbon. So all these three carbon atoms are residing in alpha position with respect to the cationic carbon center. That's why they are called alpha carbon, which are directly attached to the carbon center. Now, the number of hydrogen atom attached to this alpha carbon is called the alpha hydrogen atom. So this is called alpha hydrogen atom. In case of this tertiary butyl carbocation, the number of alpha hydrogen atom is 9. So we can draw the 9 individual hyperconjugative structure very easily, which all will be similar like this. There will be no change unless one of the hydrogens are labeled. Okay, so this is the formula or rule to calculate the number of hyperconjugative structure in a system. Now we will discuss some applications of hyperconjugation. So number one application is to determine the stability of carbocation. Here we have this methyl carbocation. Here we have this ethyl carbocation. Here we have this isopropyl carbocation, and we have also this tertiary butyl carbocation. Now in case of methyl carbocation, there is no alpha carbon present, so there is no question about alpha hydrogen, so there will be no hyperconjugation possible. So that's why zero alpha hydrogen hyperconjugation is not possible. In case of ethyl carbocation, which is 1 degree carbocation, there the number of alpha carbon is 1 and the number of alpha hydrogen we can see is 3. So we will have 3 hyperconjugative structure. Here the number of alpha hydrogen is 6. So we will have 6 hyperconjugative structure. Here the number of alpha hydrogen is 9. So we will get 9 hyperconjugative structure. So greater the number of hyperconjugative structure, greater will be the stability of the carbocation. That's why the stability order will be like this. So this is the increasing order of stability. That's why 3 degree carbocations are more stable than 2 degree carbocations, are more stable than 1 degree carbocations. It can also be explained with the help of inductive effect, which we have done before in our inductive effect video. If you have not seen yet that video, then the link is given in the description. You can visit that video also. Hope that will be useful for you. Now, if we compare the controlling power between inductive effect and hyperconjugation, then the hyperconjugation is a stronger effect than inductive effect. The hyperconjugation is although a weaker effect than resonance, but the hyperconjugation is a stronger effect than inductive effect. Okay? So this is for information which will be useful during the competitive exams. Now application number 2, to explain the stability of alkenes. Let us consider the simplest alkene, which is ethylene. In case of ethylene, we have 4 hydrogens here. Now if we start to replace one hydrogen with a methyl group, then what will happen? Like this. If we compare the stability of these alkenes, then it is found that this, the most substituted alkene here, where all the 4 hydrogens have been replaced with 4 methyl groups, is the most stable. And the stability order looks like this. So, the substituted alkenes are generally more stable. It can also be explained in terms of hyperconjugation. Here, there is no alpha carbon, there is no alpha hydrogen also, so no hyperconjugation. Here, 3 alpha hydrogen, so we get 3 hyperconjugative structure. Here, 6 alpha hydrogen, we will get 6 hyperconjugative structures. And here, 3 cross 4, which is 12 alpha hydrogen. So we will have 12 individual hyperconjugative structure. That's why this alkene is most stable among all these 4. This is an example of sacrificial hyperconjugation, and here this is an example of isovalent hyperconjugation. Now one thing is left. There is a famous experiment which is called Baker-Nathan effect, conducted by 2 scientists, Baker and Nathan. That is to observe the electron density at the para center in toluene or substituted toluene system, from which the concept of hyperconjugation has been evolved. So we will make a different video on that topic very soon. So this was our today's video about hyperconjugation. If you liked it, then give it a thumbs up. Do subscribe to our channel to watch more similar topic-wise videos on chemistry. In this channel, we make videos on the different topic-wise concepts of chemistry, which are useful for class 11-12 students, the NEET and JEE aspirants, as well as for the undergraduate chemistry students. So stay tuned, stay safe. Thanks for watching.